Friends, welcome to the second class. We saw that the Tamil alphabet is categorized into two groups. One is called vowels, the other is consonant. I would like to repeat the examples given in the last class. This is a back vowel. Then we go to O. For this, I would like to make use of two English verbs. Number one, long. Long itself is long, and you have the O sound there. And sort, S-O-R-T, sort. These are the 12 vowels which form the first part of the Tamil alphabet. Here we find two letters with an additional appendage. O, the short vowel, gets a symbol upon its arm to make it a long vowel. So also, O, to assume the ow form, ow sound, takes in a symbol. So put together, it becomes ow, like the O and the symbol put together become oom. We found that the first four are back vowels, that is A, A, E and E. U and U are labials, that is you have to make use of lips to pronounce them. A, A again get back, and then I a combination. O, O and O again labials. These are the 12 vowels which are and can be produced independently, and they support the consonants all the time. In Tamil you have another letter which is always taught and also studied along with the vowel. It is neither a vowel nor a consonant. Why so? An independent sound is called a vowel, and a dependent sound is called a consonant. And we have a letter here with three small circles put together forming a triangle. This is called akh, and this is something like the pronunciation of akh. This is pronounced as akh, and it is a triangle of three small circles. Though this is taught along with the vowels, it is not a vowel in the sense that it cannot be used independently. That is, it doesn't occur by itself. It needs two letters, one before that and the other after that. That is, this will take place only in the middle of a three-lettered word or a four-lettered word. And it is not a consonant in the sense that it cannot be made use of in combination with any vowel. So, it remains aloof but serves the purpose of a word by taking place in between two other letters. It has its own function to perform. So we will deal it when we take up the word. So this is also taught along with the vowel, but in spite of that, it is not included in the 12, and you can say it is an extra appendage to the vowel. Consonants are 18 in number. They always require the help of the vowel. This was the example given there. The word Tamil is written as Tamil in English with T-A-M-I-L. This can be split into three syllables. The first syllable has a consonant T and a vowel A. The second syllable has a consonant M and a vowel I. Whereas the last syllable is a consonant without a vowel. That's why it has to be pronounced with a stop. That is, it ends there. So a consonant will be able to be pronounced only with the help of a vowel. And this we find in all the languages. And now we shall start with the letters. The first letter is ka. It is written like this. That is, you start with a vertical line, extend it horizontally, bring it down, take further, bend it, small curve, and another horizontal line, and there is again a curve. It is written like this. The first stroke, second stroke, third extension, it is like this. This is ka. You have to practice it. As the sound ka in the letter cut. The word cut has three letters, C, U, T. One is a consonant, the other is a vowel, and the last letter is a consonant. The first two are pronounced together and the pronunciation is ka. That is equivalent to this ka. Cut. The next letter is na. Again, a vertical, horizontal, downward stroke, a loop, again horizontal, and a vertical. It is written like this. Upward stroke, horizontal, come down, take a loop, and then proceed and go up. This is na, a nasal sound. It is a nasal sound.